Welcome to Nick's Defense Channel. If you like our videos and do not want to miss our upcoming reports and would like to see our channel grow, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. This will be a series of three videos where we will take a look at the fifth generation fighter technology, existing aircraft and projects under development. In the first episode, I will explain what design features are required for an aircraft to be accepted as a fifth generation fighter jet. A fifth generation fighter is a jet fighter aircraft, which includes major technologies developed during the first part of the 21st century. As of 2021, these are the most advanced fighters in operation. The characteristics of a fifth generation fighter are not universally agreed, and not every fifth generation type necessarily has them all. However, they typically include stealth, low probability of intercept radar, agile airframes with supercruise performance, advanced avionics features, and highly integrated computer systems capable of networking with other elements within the battlespace for situation awareness, and C3. Command, control, and communications capabilities. As of March 2021, the combat-ready fifth-generation fighters are the Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor, which entered service with the United States Air Force in December 2005. The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II, which entered service with the USAF in July 2015, the Chengdu J-20, which entered service with the People's Liberation Army Air Force in September 2017, and the Sukhoi Su-57, which entered service with the Russian Air Force on the 25th of December. Other national and international projects are in various stages of development, which we will cover in episode 3 of this series. The emerging generation of advanced fighter aircraft in the first decades of the 21st century have come to be known as the fifth generation. Typical characteristics of fifth generation aircraft include stealth, with munitions stored internally, high maneuverability, which tends to include short field capabilities, supercruise, such as prolonged supersonic cruise, without the use of reheat, advanced avionics, including low probability of intercept radar, network data fusion, enabling situation awareness on the battlefield, multi-role capabilities, such as battlefield C3, command, control, and communications. In order to minimize their radar cross-section, most fifth-generation fighters use chines instead of standard leading-edge extensions and lack canards, though the Sukhoi T-50 has engine intake extensions that seem to function somewhat like canards. And the Chengdu J-20 designers have chosen the agility enhancements of canards in spite of their poor stealth characteristics. They all have twin-canted vertical tails, similar to a V-tail, also to minimize side or CS. Most fifth-generation fighters with supermaneuverability achieve it through thrust vectoring. They all have internal weapon bays in order to avoid high RCS weapon pylons. But they all have external hardpoints on their wings for use on non-stealthy missions, such as the external fuel tanks the F-22 carries when deploying to a new theater. All fifth-generation fighters have a high percentage of composite materials in order to reduce RCS and weight. All revealed fifth-generation fighters use commercial off-the-shelf main processors to directly control all sensors to form a consolidated view of the battlespace with both onboard and network sensors, while previous-generation jet fighters used federated systems, where each sensor or pod would present its own readings for the pilot to combine in their own mind a view of the battlespace. The F-22A was physically delivered without synthetic aperture radar or situation awareness infrared, search and track. It will gain SAR later through software upgrades. However, any flaw in these huge software systems can knock out supposedly unrelated aircraft systems, and the complexity of a software-defined aircraft can lead to a software crisis with additional costs and delays. By the end of 2013, the biggest concern with the F-35 program was software, especially the software required to do data fusion across the many sensors. Sukhoi calls their expert system for sensor fusion the artificial intelligence of the Su-57. Flight tests of their integrated modular avionics started in 2017 on a fiber-optic networked multi-core processor system. An automatic software response to an overheat condition apparently has contributed to at least one fatal crash of an F-22. The F-35 uses software-defined radio systems, where common middleware controls field programmable gate arrays. Colonel Arthur Tomasetti has said that the F-35 is a software-intensive airplane and software is easy to upgrade, as opposed to hardware. In order to ease the addition of new software features, the F-35 has adopted a kernel and app separation of security responsibilities. Steve O'Brien of Lockheed Martin has said that the F-35 may gain the ability to operate UAVs through a future software upgrade. The USN is already planning to place its unmanned carrier-launched airborne surveillance and strike system under the control of a manned aircraft to act as a flying missile magazine. The combination of stealthy airframes, stealthy sensors, and stealthy communications is designed to allow fifth-generation fighters to engage other aircraft before those targets are aware of their presence. Lieutenant Colonel Gene McFalls of the USAF has said that sensor fusion will feed into inventory databases to precisely identify aircraft at a distance. Sensor fusion and automatic target tracking are projected to give the fifth-generation jet fighter pilot a view of the battlespace superior to that of legacy AWACS, airborne warning and control system, aircraft that may be forced back from the front lines by increasing threats. Therefore, tactical control could be shifted forwards to the pilots and the fighters. Michael Wynn, former Secretary of the United States Air Force, has suggested elimination of the Boeing E-3 Sentry and Boeing E-8 Joint Stars in favor of more F-35s, simply because so much effort is being made by the Russians and Chinese to target these platforms that are built to commercial airliner standards. However, the more powerful sensors, such as a ESA radar which is able to operate in multiple modes at the same time, may present too much information for the single pilot in the F-22. F-35 and Su-57 to adequately use. The Sukhoi HAL FGFA offered a return to the T-seat configuration common in fourth-generation strike fighters, but this was rejected over cost concerns. There is ongoing research to apply track-before-detect across sensor fusion in the core CPU to allow fifth-generation fighters to engage targets that no single sensor has by itself detected. Probability theory is used to determine what data to believe, when to believe, and how much to believe. These sensors produce too much data for the onboard computers to fully process, so sensor fusion is achieved by comparing what is observed against preloaded threat libraries that contain known enemy capabilities for a given region. Items that do not match known threats are not even displayed. Even committed fifth-generation fighter users, such as the Israelis, concede that advances in sensors and computing will overcome a pure stealth configuration within a decade. This is why the Israelis insisted that the F-35 have defined interfaces, so that the electronic warfare systems could be constantly improved to match the threat. All known fifth-generation designs have extensive electronic warfare systems, partly in response to an incident where the limited EW systems on an F-117 may have led to its loss in combat. Stealth is now seen as part of the overall electronic warfare issue, in that a stealthy platform is easier to hide with the assistance of jamming. Chinese state media has claimed that their UHF JY-26 radar has tracked an F-22 on deployment to South Korea. Gilmary Mike Hostage III has suggested that fifth-generation jet fighters will operate together in a combat cloud along with future unmanned combat aircraft, and Michael Manazier has suggested that this might come as quickly as loading a new class with the AM or AMs to be launched at the command of an F-35. In this part of our three-episode 5th-generation fighter jet series, we covered the features and specifications of a typical 5th-generation aircraft and discussed their use on the battlespace. In episode 2, we will explain the 5th-generation aircraft that are currently in service and details. So, what is your opinion on the 5th-generation fighter jet technologies? How did it shape the battlefield so far, and what can we expect when more countries deploy their own 5th-generation aircraft in the near future? Please leave a comment with your opinions under this video. We are always looking forward to see what our viewers think. Thank you for watching Nick's Defense Channel. Please don't forget to like and hit the subscribe button located right under this video. If you want to be notified of our new uploads, click the bell button to activate your notifications. See you in our next video.